Child pose is a pose that we come into before doing movement and moving into other postures. I invite you to always start with a child pose. Wide, it's better than the knees together, because knees together, you're going to compress your belly against the thighs. It's not comfortable, it's not hugely beneficial. Open the knees. You also, by doing so, you give space for the belly to relax down. And you also start to open and loosen the hip joints that might feel tight, especially if you spend a lot of time sitting down, walking, driving, watching TV, all that sort of stuff. Child pose, the hips back, you elongate your torso and you come down. Just to relax, acknowledge your presence here on the ground and your breath. Make it long, easy, effortless, soft. You relax from the face, neck, shoulders. Let your back slowly open, allowing the breath to come between those ribs. And let the weight of the body go down. So that's the way to do the child pose. But now, for some people, if you're new to this practice and the lower back, the hip joints, everything's tight, you can, maybe you cannot bring your hips down. In that case, use a block here to receive your head, so you don't have to fight against the pose. You lower your forehead here, and then you can allow the rest of the body to go down. Adjust the position of the block, maybe much further forward, slightly back, and you relax shoulders down. Make sure when you breathe in, the belly expand and the back, because breath is movement. Sometimes we think breath, but it's not a thought. It's a process that involves muscles. So the body should be, you should be feeling your body moving as you breathe. Although it's a static pose, child pose, but the breath is always dynamic and there is movement between the ribs, movement of the belly. The chest expanding. And relax the face as you exhale. Another use, possible use of the blocks for child pose is for people who suffer from sensitive knees. Like, let's say you've got some arthritis. Arthritis developing around the cartilages inside and outside of the knees, in the meniscus cartilages. If it's the case for arthritis or any other discomfort or pain in the knees, if the pain is too sharp, avoid those sort of postures, obviously. But if it's just discomfort, even intense, that can be alleviated by using the props, the bricks. How? The pain comes from the compression bone to bone. So position the blocks at the back of the knees, between the calf and the back of the thigh. I use the blocks here, but if the edges of the blocks make your position too uncomfortable, feel free to use a big rolled towel or another yoga mat if you have one. Position it here. And then as you send your butt back, you shift the weight towards the back. This opens a bit more space in the knees, and then you come back to your child pose. And now the knee joints are a bit more spacious. There is less compression, more comfort. And come into it here. It's all about staying here for a moment until you can feel the body softening down. No rush, no pressure, literally no pressure. Relax your neck, look back, and take a few breaths here for, I don't know, 2-3 minutes. Until you feel the volume of your breath increasing slightly, the length increasing, and the rhythm becoming more equal. The length of your inhale equals the length of the exhale. Okay.
That's it. That was the use of yoga bricks for the child pose. Next tutorial will be how to use those same bricks for a different set of pose. So after child pose, we're going to see how to use those bricks in the vinyasa sequence. From cobra, upward facing dog, to downward facing dog. Thank you for watching and see you soon.